Hey everyone, Brayden here, coming to you with a breaking Disney news update, as throughout a weekend-long celebration for Mickey's 90th birthday at Walt Disney World, Disney has revealed brand new details for the Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway attraction coming to Hollywood Studios, including the Runaway Railway opening date. On Saturday, when Parks Chairman Bob Chapek gave us an hour of updates and announcements on the latest happenings and additions coming to Walt Disney World, he revealed the opening date for the Runaway Railway attraction, fall 2019. This was a bit of a surprise to me, fall 2019, because fall for Disney usually means October, November, and December. Galaxy's Edge already has a fall 2019 opening date here in Walt Disney World in the same park, and given Galaxy's Edge was never going to open by the summer, I really thought Disney was aiming for the Runaway Railway to be that thing to draw in those huge summer crowds in 2019, like they did with Toy Story Land this year and Pandora, the World of Avatar, last year. Nevertheless, whenever this attraction may open, I have a feeling it is going to become an instant classic, and dare I say, a worthy successor to the Great Movie Ride, fingers crossed. Something that made the Great Movie Ride so special is how it took you into the movies themselves. And while the Great Movie Ride itself is no more, its mission has expanded to the entirety of the park, which is becoming less and less about behind the scenes of the movies and more about being immersed inside of them. Whether that be Andy's backyard, a 14-acre land on Batuu, a planet set inside the Star Wars universe, or as will apply right here, inside a Mickey Mouse short. At the Destination D event, Bob Chapek unveiled what Disney is calling a quote, all-new cinematic nighttime experience called the Wonderful World of Animation, which is coming to the park May 2019, and looks a lot to me like a projection show that might have some pyrotechnics and other things going along with it too. In the art for the show, which we don't really have many details about just yet, you may notice that the fully decked out Runaway Railway facade is visible at the bottom of the art, where you can see that there are classic Chinese theater signs that read Mickey Mouse Gala Premiere. On the last episode of our weekly Disney news show, The Magic Weekly, I proposed some art on how Disney can do the entrance based on the new mounting plates Disney just installed you can spot protruding from the Chinese theater that are suspected to be there specifically for future Runaway Railway signage installation. And they are doing that premiere style sign I was thinking up, but Disney is going even a step further than I could have ever imagined. Because as the Imagineers revealed today at their panel on the Runaway Railway, the story of this attraction is you're in the Golden Age of Hollywood on Hollywood Boulevard, and you are going to the premiere of a Mickey Mouse short at the Chinese Theater, which in and of itself already sounds so cool. This short you're there to watch is called Mickey Mouse in Perfect Picnic, and that's exactly what you'll be doing in the queue for the attraction. At the original announcement for the ride last year, the first piece of concept art is a photo from the short itself, sort of like the short's poster that you'll be there to watch. And then you're going to board Goofy's locomotive and actually go into the short itself, where things are going to go awry. The locomotive train itself is actually made up of individual autonomous ride cars that can separate and spin off, but also go back into a train assembly. And to top that all off, just to show how in-depth Disney is going here into the theming, at the Imagineering panel, not only did they speak about the score being done by the actual composer of the current Mickey Mouse shorts with a 65-piece orchestra, but some even more in-depth things they're doing for the sound for this attraction. For example, the Runaway Railway train whistle is actually going to be Steamboat Willie's whistle from the original short. And instead of using digital sound libraries, like most do these days for special effects on these attractions, all the sound effects throughout this entire attraction are real effects made with props. So essentially, Disney is making this ride you would see a Mickey Mouse short made back in the days of Walt and the Golden Age of Hollywood with all the premieres at the Chinese Theater, all of which you'll be set in for this attraction. I think the Runaway Railway is the attraction in development right now I'm looking forward to most, because I think there's so much potential for it to be such an original, classic Disney attraction. Although it is using intellectual property in the form of Mickey, the actual story, and the characters themselves who have never had their own dedicated Disney ride, it's really gonna be something special. Let me know your thoughts on the fall 2019 opening and all of the latest as this attraction comes to life. It's so evident how well thought out this attraction is, how much work went behind the creation of the theme and the story to not only tie it in so well with the park, but also provide an authentic and innovative 2.5D adventure through an actual Mickey Mouse short, which is going to be so cool to experience. If you'd like to be notified when we drop new breaking Disney news updates, be sure to subscribe and hit that bell. Thank you so much for watching. I'll talk to you soon. This is Brayden. Have a magical day.